Hello children, hope you all are doing good at home. In the previous session of mathematics, we learnt on the chapter constructions, how to construct a triangle based on its properties. So today we are going to start with a new lesson in geometry again, that is triangles. So we all know what is a triangle, what are its properties as well. And in class 8, children, you have studied mainly about the congruency of triangles as well. What are the criteria for the congruency of triangle also we have discussed already. So we shall recall with that concepts and then move on to the actual lesson. It is a very easy lesson, children. The concepts which you know, now we are going to apply for the problems. First one is SAS congruency rule. So SAS congruency rule means side angle side congruency rule. ASA congruency rule, angle side angle congruency rule. SSS also you have studied, which is side 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 congruency rule. About all this you have learnt in class 8, I have taught you. Now we shall recall it once. What is SAS congruency rule? Here the abbreviation itself says what it is. Side angle side means if at all two sides and any included angle of a one triangle is equal to the other triangle, then those two triangles are said to be congruent to each other. The word congruent. If at all two, any two figures in general, if you consider, children, if they are same, if they are if equal size of the, if they are of equal same shape, then they both are said to be congruent. Similarly, when it comes to triangle, if at all, look now, I have drawn two triangles. We have here triangle ABC, triangle DEF. So now the three angles are angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D, angle E, and angle F. Here, if you observe, we have marked. No, what is this? Here one angle mark, here one means these two angles are equal. And the mark says these two angles are equal. That is, angle B is equal to angle E. Similarly, for angle C and angle F, you can see two angles, two lines, two means any notation you can use in order to show. Here, if you want to show three, you can put. But this has three means this also has three, and it means angle A equals angle D. This has one line, this has one line, means angle D is equal, angle B is equal to angle E. This has two means angle C is equal to angle F. Hence, triangle ABC and in triangle DEF, in order to show angles are equal, that is how we represent. Similarly, if you want to show any two sides are equal to each other, look here, for BC and DF, I have drawn a line like this, which means side BC is equal to side EF of the triangle, which means the base of the both the triangles are equal to each other. So, now, after knowing the representation, let us come back to SAS congruency, side angle side. So, if at all side AB of a triangle, here since 1, 1 I finished, 2 I will mark. Look, if at all side AB of a triangle is equal to side DE and side BC of a triangle is equal to the side EF of a triangle, and if angle B is equal to angle E, then by side angle side congruency, triangle ABC is said to be congruent to triangle DEF. I will write it and show you to make you understand better. I am writing here for SAS, children. So, from this triangle ABC and triangle DEF, if at all side AB is equal to side DE, you know, a line, the bar has to be written upon in order to represent any side or line segment, children. So that is compulsory. Simply don't write AB, BC, CD. No, you should mention it is a line. Side AB is equal to side DE of the triangle. Next up, side BC is equal to side EF, that is base of the triangle, EF of the triangle. Hence we proved 1s we got. This is 1s, one side. This is second side S. And one included angle, any angle you can say for that sake. If at all angle B is equal to angle E, then this represents one angle. One angle it will represent. So SAS, side angle side. If at all the two sides of triangle, two sides of a triangle and one included angle is equal to the same two sides, equal to the two sides and an included angle of another triangle, then these two triangles are said to be congruent to each other by SAS congruency rule. Therefore, now how do you write symbolically congruency symbol? You remember, I hope. Triangle ABC is equal to and S mark. You remember, no? Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. How? By SAS congruency rule. So next we have similarly ASA, angle side angle. So two angles and one side if you consider in case of ASA children. Same in triangle ABC and DEF. Angle B equals, if angle B is equal to angle E, one angle we got. Angle C is equal to angle F. Angle C is equal to angle F, one more side we got. And side BC is equal to side EF. If we take BC is equal to EF, means we got one side. So angle side angle, by ASA congruency rule, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. You don't have the proofs of this, children. The statements and the meaning, and you need to represent like this, you should know. This is about the criteria for congruency. So two sides or angle, included angle, two angles or one included side, if at all they are equal, of one triangle is equal to the second triangle, then though they both are said to be congruent to each other. So this is about SAS and ASA congruency rule. Now children, when we consider these two triangles ABC and DEF, if you want to prove they are congruent, then based on the given data, when we solve problems, what we do is, which side, which angle, like that, we will compare, and by using any of the congruency rule, we prove those two triangles are congruent. Case 1, what if AB is equal to DE, means, what if AB is greater than DE, how do you prove these two triangles are congruent? And if AB is less than DE, then case 3, how do we show that those two triangles are congruent? You have small steps explained there, children. Those points, just remember these three cases. Roughly I will tell you, if AB equals DE, then directly by congruency rule you can prove. But if AB is less than DE, greater than DE, so it means this side AB, it is greater than DE. So if AB is greater than DE, means what you will do is, we will choose a point P somewhere on the line AB. We will choose some point P on the side AB of the triangle. Now join that point to the third vertices C. Now what we got is triangle PBC, isn't it? Now we will prove this triangle PBC is congruent to triangle DEF. Then say, if at all this triangle PBC is congruent to triangle DEF, then since these two sides become the congruent sides of the congruent triangles, then we can say AB equals DE. That method we will prove, children. How? I will be explaining you during the online session. Okay? Clearly, I will explain you there. Similarly, in third case, if AB is less than DC, means the same what we did here, what we are about to do by marking this point P, children. That is what I wanted to tell you. ಈ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಪಿ ತಗೊಳ್ಳೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಲೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಬಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಲೆಸ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಟು ಎ ಬಿ, ಬಿ ಪಿ ಈಸ್ ಲೆಸ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಬಿ ಪಿ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಟು ಎ ಬಿ. ಸೊ ನೌ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಪಿ ಆರ್ ಪಿ ಬಿ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ದಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಡಿಇ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟ್ರೈಂಗಲ್. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸೇ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್. ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಟು ಟ್ರೈಂಗಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾನ್ಗ್ರೆಂಟ್, ಈ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗಲ್ ಈ ಡಿಇಎಫ್ ಕಾನ್ಗ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಇದ್ರೆ, then since AB and DE are sides of the congruent triangles, then of course they are also equal, and we should prove. Similarly, if AB is less than DE, andre, now we don't want point P here, but we need it on the side DE of the triangle.
So we will prove now by joining, we get triangle PEF. So we will prove triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PEF. Then again same concept of congruent sides we will use and we will prove, children. I will explain it to you neatly when I explain you during the online session. So this is about introduction to the criteria of congruency or SAS and ASA congruency rule, children. With this background, we shall start with the first exercise, that is exercise 5.